Welcome to Blackboard Basics for Faculty, a sabbatical project in collaboration with the Faculty Center for Student Success at Saddleback College. This is a 7-part video series, and today we will cover Part 5, Contact Information and Resources and Links. These videos are specific to the South Orange County Community College District, but they are designed to help everyone using Blackboard. The Blackboard interface used in these videos is version 9.1. Interface design changes with certain updates, but many of the items covered in these videos have remained constant or been improved with each update. These videos are to help faculty who teach face-to-face classes use Blackboard to enhance their courses. If you are a student looking for Blackboard help, please see Blackboard Basics for Students, linked below. Part 5, Contact Information and Resources and Links. In this video, we will cover 1. Adding contact information. 2. Adding resources and links. Number 1. Adding contact information. In Part 2, Welcome to Blackboard, Your First Blackboard Shell, we added a navigation link for contact information. In this video, we are going to add information to that link. In your Blackboard shell, be sure your edit mode is on and click on your contact information link. You have two options, create folder or create contact. Click create contact. And here we will enter our contact information. Number 1, profile information. Enter your profile information in this section, including your office location and office hours and any notes to your students. Option 2, make the profile available. Yes. You can also add an image of yourself to your contact information and a personal link if you have a faculty webpage you want to link here. The recommended image size is 150 by 150 pixels. Number 3, submit. Click submit. Here is your contact information. While we are on this page, think about other contact information your students might need for your class. I create contacts for the Student Technical Support Services that Saddleback College has for our students, and then I also create a page for the Saddleback Library. I went to each of the websites for these groups and added the information from the websites here. Including the link to the page allows students to click straight from Blackboard to their websites. Here is what our contact page looks like now. Number 2, adding resources and links. Now we're going to add resources and links to our Blackboard course. This is a place for you to add additional documents and resources for your class. Make sure your edit mode is on and click resources and links. Now a note about naming this section. I call it resources and links, but you might want to call it other course documents. When you create your own Blackboard course, think about the vocabulary that matches your course and use that vocabulary when you create your menu navigation. In this section, we are going to add some resources and links for our students. If you didn't add student technical support or library information in the contacts area, be sure to add it here. I'm going to create a folder with the library information today and show you how to create a folder. Folders are good for keeping documents all together for students. Click Build Content, Content Folder. Number 1, Content Folder Information. Name your folder. I name mine. Click here, Library Hours, Phone Numbers, Workshops, etc. Then I add text to go under the folder name. Number 2, Standard Option. I leave as the default of Permit Users to View This Content equals Yes. And I leave the dates blank so the library folder is always visible. Number 3, submit. I click submit. Here I've created a folder and this is what it looks like. To add content to my folder, I click on the name of the folder, click here, library hours, phone numbers, workshops, etc. In the folder, I can now add whatever content I would like, just like we have done in the previous videos. In the case of the Saddleback Library, I have something special that I do. It is a little beyond Blackboard basics, but if you are a faculty member at Saddleback College, contact me, Elizabeth Horan, Distance Learning Librarian at Saddleback College, To learn about the pilot project I am working on to embed library information in Blackboard using Google Drive. The library information looks like this, and I update the content every semester so you don't need to worry about updating it. We will talk in part 7 about how you can reuse what you have created in all these videos. Back on the resources and links page, I added links for student technical help, tutoring services, and the Saddleback College Student Handbook. I did this using Build Content, Web Link, going through the steps we covered in this series. This section of your Blackboard course can be rich with resources and other documents for your students. Think of ways you can use it for your classes. This completes part 5, Contact Information and Resources and Links. In this video, we covered 1. Adding contact information. 2. Adding resources and links. Our course went from looking like this to this. Thank you so much for joining me for Blackboard Basics for Faculty, using Blackboard to enhance a face-to-face class. Leave any questions or comments below, and I will do my best to get back to you. Please join me for part 6, where we will cover grades and grading assignments in Blackboard.